Okay, I'm rolling.
My name is Holly King. I'm a psychology student at the University of Oregon. In 2008, I saw a news report about 30 elite scientists that had gotten together in a remote area of the Ural Mountains in Russia. They were trying to solve a mystery that had baffled the world for almost 50 years. It had become known as the Dyatlov Pass Incident after a leader of an expedition there in 1959 named Igor Dyatlov. They failed, but I was riveted by the story. So when my favorite professor, Dr. Kittles, assigned the class a project on that very same incident, I couldn't believe it. I mentioned it to a buddy of mine, Jensen, a film student here, and he said that we should make a film. So we applied for a grant, and we got it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us what happened.
I first heard about the incident when a Russian journalist named Yuri Yerovoy published a fictionalized account of it in a book.
Of course, they had him killed. I mean, it didn't matter that he fictionalized it. They didn't want anybody talking about Dyatlov.
And I began using the facts of the incident as a teaching exercise in psychology because there's so much that we know about what happened at Dyatlov's Pass, so many details, and yet the whole thing remains shrouded in mystery.
What are some of the explanations that you tend to get?
The most common cold scientific explanation I get is a condition called hypothermic dementia.
Hypothermic dementia. Yeah, that is literally what everybody says. But my favorite is paradoxical undressing.
That does actually happen, though, to people suffering with severe hypothermia. They get disoriented, think that they're overheating, and then start taking off their clothes.
Come on, Holly. These were 9 experienced backpackers.
Yeah.
You're telling me that they all got severe hypothermia at the same time on the same night?
Maybe.
They've been out there for 3 days already. Why then?
An avalanche is another frequent answer.
That is even stupider than paradoxical undressing.
Why?
If they could hear an avalanche, then why did they stay away from the camp for 3 hours with no shoes?
But in truth, there are innumerable answers to the question. Most of my students will project their own fears onto it.